Hi, good morning and good evening. Welcome to Mainframe Tutorial. You are watching Mainframe Videos JCL Tutorial 8. So, in this video, I would like to share about the GDG, which is one of the important concepts in the JCL language. What does GDG? What does GDG stand for? And where do we use this GDG? And what is the significance of GDG? And how important plays a role in when handling with the high volume of data in mainframe environment. So let's go ahead and look into the details of the GDG. GDG stands for Generation Data Group. It is a collection of multiple sequential data sets with same attributes with unique data set names. So here it will have a standard base creator, and it will have a multiple generations to a standard name. Okay. The attributes like record length, record format, dataset type, and the block size is created. See, I can give you some real-time example. So, I'm working in one of the insurance company. So, or you can take the banking sector. See, so daily a trading or a transactions. Daily transactions happens. It might be a weekly transactions. They wanted to have separate transactions created. There is a weekly transactions, monthly transactions, and a quarterly or something else. So what I will do is I can create a standard GDG base with having creating a dataset name with something TSO dot user dot a week. I will give a standard. Let me type it here, like TSO dot something, TST dot accounts dot week. So this I will create a standard base. So this base, I want to track the information of the data. I want to store day to day data into this base. So I want to keep track of the weekly's information to a standard to a specific data set name. How do I remember? Instead of giving multiple names, so what I will do is just I will define a base and keep on adding the generation to this base. So which help me to easily to track and easily to understand. In the same way, I can have a monthly base created and added generations. So I hope this would be helpful. The steps to create a GDG. There are mainly three steps in order to create a GDG. Creating a GDG base and adding a data set to a base, that is adding generation to a base, and accessing generation, that is accessing data sets. So GDG, these are the three important steps. So first is creating a GDG base and creating a data sets or adding a generations and accessing the generations. Creating a GDG base, then adding generations to this GDG base, and then accessing the generation. In order to add a generation, you need to add a plus one, and in order to access the generation, it should be 0, minus 1, or minus 2. So now the question comes, how to create a base? So it is a user defined name, must be formed between 1 to 44 alphanumeric character. The base name is created with IBM utility called IDCAMS. For one base name, maximum 255 data sets can be created, that is between 1 to 255. Can choose any number of generation as per your project requirements. So let's straight away look into the example. This is the job card, and you need to use the IDCAMS as the utility in order to create a base. So define GDG is the standard definition you need to give in this parameters. So you give your standard, what I can say, your base name, the limit. I want to use maximum 45 generation to my billing, and the scratch, no scratch, empty, no empty. These are the very different parameters we pass it to define GDGs. So let's see what is scratch, what is no scratch, what is empty and no empty. Scratch, it deletes all generations with when limit is reached. Okay. And no scratch, it deletes only oldest generation when limit is reached. empty. It uncatalog all generations when limit is reached. It uncatalog only oldest generation when limit is reached. So now we are created the base. Now we will add a generations. So how to add a generations or data set to base? Adding a base name to the generation is same like PS. Normally how do we create a PS? In the same way we can create a generation. It should be coded with +1 and dispositional parameter must be new catalog. So the same the job card, you use IB general as a utility. So this is your building, and what does it? It copies the data from this to this, the new generation data. See, observe, this is unit and this is test. Okay, so here you have to specify all the disposition, space, recall and these things. So what is happening over here is daily I receive a billing data from a upstream system to a normal data set. So where I want to make a copy of those, just I wanted to make a copy, keep a copy. I mean, as I said in my example, I wanted to maintain a weekly database, weekly generations. So every day I will receive a data with a standard master file, and I need to backup. I created with something like test billing +1. So it keeps on adding to this up to the maximum 45. So this is the way we add a generation or data set. So how to access the generation? So GDG dataset can be accessed by using base name with 0 to access current generation, -1 to access previous generation, and -2 to access next generation. It is simple. So if you want to access it, if you can give 0, that's it. If you the present generation, the -1, if you want to access the previous day data or the previous days. So based on the generation, you can go to -3, -4, -5. 0 is the latest and the -1 is the oldest and -2 is the previous days. So in this way you can create multiple generations. So you access the generations. I hope you all enjoyed this video. That's all. This is all about the GDG. I would be coming up with more important topics in JCL, COBOL, CICS and DB2. Keep watching, keep subscribing these videos. If you like this video, share it or comment on this video. Thank you for watching. Have a great and wonderful evening.